Sir? Are you alright? I'll call an ambulance.
No ambulance.
You're badly hurt. You need a doctor.
Please, just help me to my room. It's number 207.
You got the key? You're really in bad shape. You should see a doctor.
Must have one, maybe two broken ribs. It's not fatal. But it's sore as hell.
Your head is bleeding. It looks deep. He's in trouble. I can't just walk away and leave him like that. I'll help him first and ask questions later. Paraphenol anti-fever. Administer only in cases of high fever. Necafrin 100 antibiotics. Administer to combat infection. Here. Take this. It should do you some good.
What is it?
It's an antibiotic.
An antibiotic. I'm no doctor, but I don't think there's any risk of infection with a broken rib.
Okay, I'll see if I can find anything else. Paracetamol painkiller. Administer in cases of intense pain. Do not take more than one pill every 24 hours. I should disinfect his cuts. I'm gonna disinfect your wound. This might hurt a little. Sorry. Are you okay? There. At least it won't get infected.
Thanks.
Paracetamol painkiller. Administer in cases of intense pain. Do not take more than one pill every 24 hours. Here. Take this. It should do you some good. It's a painkiller. It'll help reduce the pain. It says on the box to take one every 24 hours. I don't think it's a good idea to exceed the dose.
I can't afford to wait.
I wouldn't move around for a few days if I were you.
I'm gonna take a shower.
All right, let me help you. I'll wait here until you come out. Let me know if you need anything. Talk to me. That way I'll know if you pass out.
What's your name?
Madison.
Are you staying in the hotel?
No, I live in town. I suffer from chronic insomnia. I seem to only be able to sleep in motels. Don't ask me why. Whenever I get too exhausted, I come and spend a night here.
I'm just passing through. And what else do you do, Madison? Apart from fixing up strangers.
I'm a photographer. I take pictures of furniture for fashionable design magazines. And you?
I'm an architect.
Thanks for staying. I feel a lot better now.
Okay. I better get going then. By the way, you never told me your name.
Ethan.
Be careful, Ethan.
Was that the first time?
Sorry?
First time you killed somebody. It always does something to you the first time. Then you get used to it.
I'm not sure I want to get used to it. That's him.
Miroslav Korda?
Yeah?
Lieutenant Carter Blake, I'd like to ask you some questions.
Shit, don't just stand there! He's gonna get away! Hey man, watch it!
Watch it, man! Whoa! Whoa!
This time it looks like we got our origami killer.
You said I could contact you if I remembered anything. Can I come in?
Sure. You want a drink?
Yes, glass of water, please.
Take a seat, I'll get it.
Thanks. I just remembered something. Maybe it's not important, but a letter arrived in the mail the morning Johnny disappeared.
A letter? What kind of a letter?
It was addressed to Johnny's father. I don't know what was inside it, but he read it and then he left. That's the last time I saw him.
And you think there's a connection between that letter and Johnny's death, is that it? You remember anything else about the letter?
Well, I don't know why, but I kept the envelope.
It was mailed in the Carnaby district the day before Johnny disappeared. Oh, nothing particular. Except the address.
The address?
It was typed with an old typewriter. Could be a lead, you never know. Well, thanks for your help, Lauren. I'll let you know if it leads to anything.
Wait, I can't just sit around and do nothing while you're out there looking for the man who killed my son. Ever since you came around, I've been thinking, and I want to come with you. Help you in your investigation?
The answer is no.
If you won't let me help you, I'm keeping the envelope. It's all or nothing.
Listen, an investigation like this is dangerous, and I don't have time to play the bodyguard.
How many clues have you got, Mr. Shelby? This envelope may be your only link to the killer. I understand. It was a stupid idea. Sorry for wasting your time, Mr. Shelby.
Wait. You're really something special, Lauren. I'll give you that.
I'm just a mother. A mother who wants to find out who killed her son. Are we partners?
We're partners. Maybe you better stay in the car.
We're partners, remember? Wherever you go, I go. What are we doing here?
We come to see Gordy Kramer.
Kramer? The bigwig tycoon from Kramer Construction.
No, his son.
You think maybe he's the origami killer?
For now, I just have a few questions that need answers.
Time. Are we gonna be here long? This place gives me the creeps.
I'm gonna go find Gordy Kramer. You stay here till I come back, okay?
Okay. Just let me know if you need me.
Well, I'm here. Might as well have a drink. Don't know why they have that goddamn music so loud. Can't hear myself thinking. Not gonna be easy to find Gordy behind that big wall of paid gorillas.
Excuse me. I'm looking for Gordy.
I saw him going.